Jiggy, you had the A1 longer than
I did. Basically for about 3 days, three shooting days, yeah.
So we're going to give our initial thoughts on the camera
based
on our experience for the past couple of days. First things first, what were your expectations first when it was launched?
Yeah, you know, this has been something that I've been looking for the past 7 years, 8 years, 9 years actually, since I shifted to Sony in 2013. So the expectations were really high because finally the technology caught up that we could bring in all the features that I loved in the other Sony cameras and put it in one, because that's what everybody's been asking for, an all-in-one Sony camera.
Yes.
So when they launched this, when they announced it, I was like, is this the one? That's why it's called the Alpha One, right? So is this the one? So I was so excited to try it, and yeah, it is the one. It
and
really is.
There's a difference between, of course, the expectations
and reality
and your impressions, because
you
held the camera first
before
me.
Well, it felt familiar, but it felt different.
Because?
The body was very similar to the original or to the Sony Alpha cameras that I've been using now, but it felt so different because it just felt like it was a beast waiting to be explored. It felt like it had so much to give. Since it wasn't just a single camera, or it wasn't a camera for a single purpose, it allowed me to create basically explore all the creative mediums that I wanted to explore without having to bring in multiple setups. That's why I felt that the moment I got it, it felt very, very similar. It felt very familiar, but I knew there was so much that was really inside this camera.
Mm-hmm. My initial thoughts was, I thought that when I get a hold of the A1, I'll be like overwhelmed.
Okay.
Because it's 50 megapixels and then it
shoots. Because you're not used to it, because you shoot with, what do you shoot with now? The S3.
You have the S3 and then of course you have the R4, but having that 8K resolution, I thought this might be bigger. This might, you know, be harder to shoot.
In which I was
wrong.
Oh well, we'll talk about that later. I want to ask you about how you were able to edit the files since you were shooting in 8K, because this is one of the first in a prosumer camera.
Yep.
Right.
In its form.
So 8K.
Without overheating.
Yeah. Right. So that's why exactly. Like for example, with me as a content creator, I'm first a portrait photographer, then a wedding photographer.
You shifted now.
Now I'm a content creator because of what's been happening in the world right now, right? So I've never really shot in 8K, nor have I ever imagined that I would be shooting in 8K. 4K was more than enough for
me. Actually, 4K still.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Then I'm pretty sure you were as blown away as I was.
Yes.
Anyway, we're getting ahead of ourselves, but we have notes. Okay.
We're going to talk about two things.
Two things, yes.
Today. Speed and resolution, because that's what's the A1 is.
Wow.
Let's start with speed.
Speed.
Okay.
Exactly.
Go ahead.
Well, you know how when you're shooting, time is essential, especially with me when I'm shooting outdoor, you can't control the weather. The moment you've got a good sunset, you got to shoot, you got to shoot fast. Your camera should never hinder you with what you're doing.
Yep.
The focusing system, the new shutter mechanism of that camera, of the Sony Alpha 1, was fantastic. Let's talk about that first. That shutter mechanism, when you hear it, when you hear the sound of the shutter, you'll know it's a totally different beast inside
the
camera.
It's different.
It's different.
And I've read it's now made, I think, of carbon fiber or something similar.
No wonder. I never really got into that detail. That's why I'm sure you've read more about that than I have. But I just knew when I clicked that shutter, it just felt so different.
It's different.
It was different. Plus, it actually changed the way I approach lighting outdoor. Because one of my limitations prior to using the Alpha 1 was my flash sync speed.
Mm-hmm.
My flash sync speed was normally over 1 over 250 at a maximum. And with Alpha 1, I was able to do 1 over 400. 1 over 400 gives me an additional stop of light. In other words, because when you're shooting with outdoor photography and you're using flash like the Sony F60 RM, that flash only affects your aperture.
Yes.
Shutter speed is what we use to control our ambient light. So the more we're able to control our ambient light, the more powerful our flash becomes.
And 1 over 400, this is not high-speed sync.
No, it's not even high-speed sync. Exactly. So because when you do high-speed sync, you lose a lot of power. So when you go if you go beyond your flash sync speed, then you're in the realms of high-speed sync.
Yeah. And so you have to use bigger lights.
You have to use bigger lights, or you have to use two, or you have to... There's so many techniques that you could do, but with this one, it just made it faster.
Mm-hmm.
Because for me to be able to use those bigger lights, it's more cumbersome to use. Plus, if I shot an APS-C, you could go up to 1 over 500. That's crazy. Another... That's for me, it's already going to the realms of the leaf system.
Exactly.
Remember that? Mm-hmm. With the medium formats and the leaf lenses. Now, of course, with a small camera, you could do 1 over 400 and 1
exactly.
over 500.
And this is because of the new shutter system.
Yes.
That doesn't only sync the flashes using mechanical shutter. You can now, right?
Yeah, you could use the electronic shutter with that one. So it's just crazy that the technology is it's constantly evolving. That photographers now have to catch up in terms. Remember how we used to say that when it's a photographer that carries the camera, or you upgrade your camera when you've reached the limits of what your camera can
do.
Right? With this particular camera, they actually changed the limits of what we normally could do. So we are the ones adjusting to the technology in order for us to
imagine
be able to maximize
electronic
it.
Shutter, and then you sync your flash.
Exactly right. It's really crazy. So. What are the advantages? You know more about this than me, because for me, this is something that's very new to me because it's never been done. So what are the advantages of shooting with electronic shutter and flash?
Well, number one, I personally think when you use mechanical shutter, you still feel the vibration.
Yes, that's one, yes.
Imagine the freedom that you'll have.
Yes.
When aiming for the rear subject.
And blackout-free.
Blackout-free.
Yeah, you're right.
Just imagine
that. Yeah, I'm sorry. I've only had it for a few days, and I really just tested the ones that stood out for me. You know that I'm a dinosaur when it comes to these things, right? So I will evolve to the camera. It's not the camera evolving to me, but I will be evolving to that camera.
You're already talking about blackout-free.
Yeah.
You tested the 30 FPS. How was your experience? Your face.
Holy cow. You know, as I said, I was using the camera with a notion of old school photography or what I was used to. So I've never really shot an electronic shutter. So when they said that Alpha 1 can shoot in 30 frames per second, my mentality was I needed to bring up the shutter speed for me to reach 30 frames per second.
Mm-hmm.
And when I was shooting, I was like, it didn't seem as if I was shooting in 30 frames per second. I was shooting dancers at that time, right? So I would normally have to time the peak of the jump to be able to get the full form.
Mm-hmm.
But then I was so excited because I wanted to shoot with 30 frames per second. One shot and for sure I'll get everything, right? So when I tried it, I said, it wasn't working.
Mm.
Then I realized, or you told me actually, that I needed to use the CF Express card.
A faster card.
I was using an old card. Yeah. So it was just 95, so it wasn't really enough. So a 300 should be enough, right? I don't really need to go for CF Express to do that. And then when you shifted it to electronic shutter, I was like this. I was literally...
That's it?
Why wasn't I shooting like this?
That's it?
That's exactly what we were talking about. Speed relates to time.
Yeah.
I wasted so much time when I could have honestly gotten the shot in the first minute.
Yeah.
And I could have moved on to the next layout, to the next lighting pattern. This is something that the camera actually bought for me that you can't buy.
Yeah.
You can't buy time, you know that, right? So now we can do so much with so little time.
Exactly.
Fantastic.
You've mentioned about dancers and
you
know, the precise and exact moment.
Yes.
The A1 has good focusing system as well.
Oh, fantastic. You know, the technique that I used to do when I would shoot dancers is I would make them go to a point where they will jump.
Yep.
So if they need to, run to in order for them to
for
get
your
the
frame,
jump,
right?
For my frame, right? They're going to run out of frame and then go to a certain point, and that's where they do their final movement.
Mm-hmm.
The focusing system of the Alpha 1 basically just tracked them anywhere they went.
Exactly. Even if they're out of frame first, right?
Yeah, so if they're out of frame, then all of a sudden they enter the frame. Automatically, the camera will just look for that face, and then follow them wherever they go, and I can just keep the shutter pressed, and that was it.
So you know, just imagine 30 frames per second.
You know, I could have actually given it to the client afterwards and say, hey, here, make a picture book.
Yeah. Because right? All the form, right? The sequence.
Everything, the sequence yeah. was there. So honestly, I really think that we will do that afterwards. Mm-hmm. With this particular shoot, mm-hmm. the main requirement was really to just get the full form. Mm-hmm. But as an add-on now, I will actually give them a frame-by-frame shot just to show the movement.
30 frames.
30 frames per second. And I didn't even need to go up to 1/1,000.
Yes. And all in focus.
All in focus. It was just so crazy.
No focus hunting.
So crazy. See, that those are the things that, as I said earlier, I had to relearn how to shoot because of the technology.
You will adjust for the camera.
I am adjusting to the camera. Exactly.
We're talking about focusing now. And I just came across this feature. We love IAF.
Yes.
There's IAF, yes. And then Sony said, you want animals? Okay, we'll give you animal IAF.
Yes, yes.
But the A1, this A1,
yes.
Let me give you bird AF.
I know. It's just crazy. Coupled with the 200 to 600 yes. lens. Yes, from Sony.
We'll give you bird AF.
Yeah. It's just crazy. 30 frames per second, animal AF, bird AF, fantastic tracking.
Just imagine.
Imagine for the bird photographers, they're really gonna go wild with this
just
camera.
Imagine.
Which, if I had more time, mm-hmm. I actually would have wanted to become a bird photographer. It might have, you know, imagine me not
because
knowing
you're
how to
already
shoot
here.
Birds.
Yes, you're already here.
We're in a beautiful place here with a lot of birds. So maybe one of these days, you guys come back and lend me the camera again.
You know, I just remembered this right now. When I was still working for the magazine, for a photography magazine, the number one problem for bird photographers when they submit bird pictures, the resolution.
Oh yeah.
Because of course, yes, they can zoom in, but they still have to really punch in.
Yes.
Enable for you to get the close up. So imagine with the A1, 50 megapixels.
You've got 50 megapixels.
Bird AF, IAF, right?
And not just that, you've got 50 megapixel and you've got fantastic dynamic range.
Exactly.
That dynamic range. Resolution for you.
We're now talking about resolution, right?
Okay. It's crazy. I'm coming from the A7R, so I expect nothing but the best also here in the Alpha 1, but it's something very new to you.
Yes.
Yes. So how do you find it?
Who would have thought in this small form factor, it will shoot 8K?
Crazy, right?
Without overheating.
Crazy.
That's the biggest factor there.
Yeah.
There are a couple of cameras right now on the same form factor that shoots 8K, but after 10, 15 minutes, it's just,
and
just
they
die.
And they can't do 30 frames per second. And it doesn't focus as fast.
So,
it doesn't have 50 megapixel too.
8K shooting.
Yeah,
and then,
8K shooting. So what are the advantages of 8K shooting?
Well, of course, you get the resolution that you want.
Okay.
And when you downsample to 4K.
Okay.
Imagine now you're downsampling to 4K.
Yeah, exactly. Remember when we used to shoot at 4K and downsample to
Full
HD?
Yes. Now you can downsample to 4K.
You can downsample.
And then that was my initial thought is, these files are huge, hard to edit.
Before that, Nige, when you say 8K, is it actually four times more than 4K? Remember when HD went to 4K, it was four times bigger.
On computation,
it's four times bigger again.
Yes.
So in other words, you can crop to four times more and go to 4K. Okay,
You're safe in six.
Okay.
So my initial test when I was here, I'm going to test, of course, how my computer performs.
Exactly.
I was expecting big files, but I also expected that my camera is going to cry.
Yeah, no, your computer.
Yeah.
Your computer's going to cry.
Your computer is going to cry, but it didn't.
So that's how manageable the files were made.
Yes. It has the H.265 codec.
Okay.
So smaller files compared to H.264. Okay. But I was really surprised on how workable the files are.
So
on 8K.
So are you suggesting, let's say I do content for YouTube, right? So with my talking heads or when I'm shooting, I should shoot in 8K so that I can zoom in and crop more.
You can have three cameras.
I can crop to 4K. I can literally crop to 4K now.
Yes.
Oh, that's very interesting.
Yes. And of course, we all know that the 8K resolution, what I really like about this one is the color science.
Yeah.
For video, it inherits the color science of the FX9, the FX6, and the S3.
Wow.
It has the S-Cinetone, which is, everyone's raving about the S-Cinetone.
Yes, can you explain S-Cinetone?
S-Cinetone is, of course, it's a color science, gamut and gamma.
Okay.
But it has better mids. Okay. It's friendlier on mids.
So when you say acetone, it's basically getting the proper exposure for all. In other words, it's the closest that you can get to what the human eye actually sees.
Not really, but it has this film.
Okay. Oh, look, okay, okay.
Film
okay.
feel.
Okay, okay.
Same as the FX9 and okay. the FX6.
All right, so it's me, not a non-videographer asking stupid questions. I'm sorry about that.
No, it's okay, but you know, that's why everybody loves Acetone. It's because okay. it's baked in, meaning minimal color grading.
Okay.
But straight from the camera, it's already beautiful.
Oh, which reminds me, that's the reason why I was asking about the naked eye, right? Because whenever I see videographers using the picture profiles mm-hmm. or those settings that I've never really yeah. delved into mm-hmm. when it comes to the Alpha system, is that when I am shooting side by side with them, I see my highlights clipped or my shadows mm-hmm. really dark. Mm-hmm. And then when I see it with video, everything just really looks very mm-hmm. flat. Why is that? How does that sensor now, or how does the 8K help in doing that? Is it better? Does it give you better dynamic range?
You're talking already about it.
The dynamic range.
Yes. Imagine.
So it applies also to video.
Yes, it applies to video, but of course on a different spectrum.
Yeah, exactly.
But
so how
imagine
does it
this: before you have like a box of 8 crayons to use for your color.
Okay.
Now you have like 3,200 crayons to choose from.
Okay.
So you have this artistic freedom.
Okay.
Whatever you look you want.
Yes.
When you use, of course, this Gamma S-Log SLR-3
yes.
On the new A1 or the S3. But with the A1, it inherits the same color science of, you know, the FX series.
So basically, with me as a photographer, because I've tested the A1, and yes, it is the RAW is already supported mm-hmm. in some of the RAW conversion softwares. Mm-hmm. And I was able to pull out 3 to 4 stops.
Yeah, you're talking about dynamic range, right?
Easy. Mm-hmm. And in my shadow, in my mm-hmm. shadow details, 3 to 4 stops, no problem whatsoever.
Clean, right?
Clean.
Clean.
Crazy. So that's the same when it comes to video, right? On 8K.
8K, of course, yeah.
Okay. How about your ISO? How is it?
ISO, it's still clean on my initial test.
Okay.
So this might be a little bit, you know, sorry, Sony, but... it has cleaner outputs on non-base ISOs.
Okay, so you're saying that it might have dual ISO also?
I cannot say for now if it has dual ISO.
Because we
like haven't... Like the S3, yeah. Because we haven't really
tested it. Yes.
But the base ISO, for example, for S-Log 3 is 800.
Okay.
When you go to 1000, 1250, 1600, it's still clean.
Okay.
This is when we are shooting now on like pitch black. It's already 7-8 p.m.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Crazy.
Let's talk about the HDR, your dynamic range.
Okay.
When you shot here on, I think that was 2 p.m.
Well, at 2 p.m. is not a problem. 2, 3 p.m. bright sunlight is not a problem. But when I tested it, I actually shot footage I actually shot my wife underneath a tree. And I exposed for highlights outside the tree.
Exactly.
So I controlled my highlights because, as you know, with photography, I'd rather control my highlights because the shadows are easier to recover than highlights and blown highlights. So I always try to control my highlights. When I controlled my highlights, the shadow with my wife was already in shadow was put more into shadow. So I think I was pushing it to about 4, 5, 6 stops underexposed. I'm not really sure. I will check my files again. But definitely 4 stops underexposed, I was able to bring out all the details in the shadows.
Imagine, man.
So it allowed me, that's my expectation. To be honest, it's an expectation because I came already from the A7 R4, the A7 R3, or basically most Sony cameras have fantastic dynamic range. But of course, the R series is really built for photo.
Yes.
So I expected the Alpha 1 to be at least close to the A7 R Mark IV. But it's not close. It's the same. It didn't feel any different except for the 10 megapixel drop in resolution. Mm. So technically, if you really want to think about it, we just threw away one of our old cameras in the 10 megapixels. Or the resolution of that we just lost the resolution of, let's say, for example, the A7 S3, but we still have 50.
I know.
Imagine that. We still have 50. We gave away the resolution of one camera, and we have 50
remember
left.
Remember before, you just, I have a 10 megapixel.
Yeah, 10 megapixel camera. And we're like, whoa, really? 12? Whoa, those are flagship cameras before. And now we're just giving it away. Oh, I don't even see the difference. We're good already with 50 megapixel. It's more than enough.
So in the future now, because we're talking about the past, in the future now, how do you see the A1 benefiting your work?
I can expect my wallet to suffer. Seriously. Because I was so happy using just a photo-centric camera. Mm-hmm. But because of the way times are changing, it's no longer just photos. It's also content creation. So I also want to be able to have a camera that can shoot fantastic video. And I've always loved, to be honest, I've always loved the A9. That camera has always piqued my curiosity because for wedding photography, especially for events, there are times that I really need that fast frame rate. Now I have everything in the Alpha 1, right? So it is destined to be my go-to camera. If there's only one camera that I could get out of my bag, it will be that, guaranteed.
Yeah, I only have 2 points for this particular camera. How will it benefit creators in the future? First is the creative freedom that you'll have.
Super.
I think you were set free when you used that electronic shutter 30 frames. Like, that's it. Next.
Imagine this one, practical application. Bride walking down the aisle.
Yeah.
Bride walking down the aisle, first time she's going to see the groom. Mm-hmm. You're right behind the bride, fantastic focusing. It's just going to focus on the groom because the bride has her back turned. Mm-hmm. One click, two clicks, 2 seconds for the groom to hit the bride. Mm-hmm. I have everything.
Exactly.
The bride hugging the mom. I have it. The bride hugging the dad. Click. I have it. Right? With the and the best thing about it, we are inside the church. They won't even hear the shutter.
Exactly.
Right?
So and practical. We're talking about wedding. I'm not a wedding videographer, but just imagine the position of, for example, the videographer.
Yes, especially now. You can't go near.
Yeah, of course.
Yes.
But shoot in 8K.
Yes.
You have your wide shot.
Then
you have your wide shot.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. So that's why right now, then for my studio work, I've got 50 megapixels.
Exactly.
Then for outdoor shooting, I can do cropped and still bring it down to 21 megapixel and shoot at 1 over 500. So as we demoed, remember I showed you from the 24 millimeter, I cropped it to a 35 millimeter. So now I have a 24 millimeter and I have a 35 millimeter all in one lens, right?
Exactly.
So, and just losing what? Half your resolution, which is still 20 megapixel. Crazy.
Yeah,
crazy.
So that's it. The A1 gives us this creative freedom that we didn't expect we will have on testing the camera. And I like what you said. It will push you again creatively.
Yes. It will make you adjust to the camera. The technology is now ahead of the technology is now ahead of the capabilities of the photographer boxed in. So now we are allowed to think out of the box because the camera is thinking out of the box. It's really just gone out of the box and created something new.
Imagine what other creators
can do. For sure. Imagine what we could have done if we had it for a week or two or three or four, right?
Or forever.
Forever. Yeah. Sony. Right? So we had it for 2 days. Mm-hmm. And I haven't even really played around with that electronic shutter because I just figured out how to do it.
Just imagine the possibilities.
Imagine the possibilities. And I think this is the time that we quote whatever it is that you're seeing. Whatever it is that you always say about the Sony camera. What do you say about the Sony camera?
Tell it to me.
Remember how you would always say that Sony is always ahead. In other words, there are things that they put in the cameras that we don't understand why they put it there. Then eventually we will find the reason and why they put it there. They know it even before we actually need it. So they are creating something that they know we will be needing in the future. And I feel that the Sony Alpha 1 is that camera again.